and so on and so forth. Hello everyone, this is Warren, and I'm here with another tutorial of a Radiohead song, surprise, surprise, and it's Go to Sleep. Now, a word of warning to you guys who want to attempt this one and you're not really sure if you can do it or not, I'll warn you, it's a challenge. It's going to take a lot of time, a lot of patience, and a lot of effort and repetition. And I don't like using the word practice, you know, but yeah, it takes a lot of practice. And, you know, I nearly injured my fingers. Well, injured meaning, you know, I almost got blisters from playing this a couple days ago. I was playing them raw for like a couple hours. And I don't know if you guys ever play that much straight. And you know, I have medium gauge strings on my guitar. Julian, say hello, Julian. And yeah, man, whew, I had to back off and spend like a couple days and, you know, watch my calluses kind of return to full strength. But it was, yeah, just needless to say, this is a challenge. So without any further ado, I just want to get to the rest of this tutorial here. Gonna try to simplify it. You know, you guys know if you've been watching my channel that I like to take complex things and simplify them. It's just like my passion in life. It's my delight. EADGBE is the tuning. That's standard tuning. Thank goodness. You know, we have a song in standard tuning, which is pretty rare for Radiohead. And you're gonna be doing this shape a lot. Okay, you're gonna have your ring finger and your middle finger on the same fret. I'm going to be doing a lot of moving around. See that? They're all kind of like parallel moving things, shapes, okay? The shape is moving parallel. And you're going to get really used to that. And while you're doing this, you're almost always going to mute the fifth string, okay, and the first string. So if I strum this right here, you should only hear the sixth, the fourth, the third, and the second. You shouldn't hear the first or the fifth string. So practice that and get that to the point where you can safely do that anywhere. And just kind of keep your fingers rigid so that the muting is still happening. I actually mute with my pinky and the fleshy part of my middle finger for the fifth string there. So the first thing you want to do is slide from the first to the third fret using this shape. And then you're going to depress your pinky on the first string there to form a full G chord, except that it doesn't have a B. Okay, so full meaning all six strings, but not full in the sense it doesn't have a B, which is its third, music theory people. So slide from the first fret. You're gonna kind of just strum mostly the lower strings, slide over, and hit the rest of the chord. Okay, and then you're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, what happened there? Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so if you notice, I just did 1, 2, 3, 4. Basic strum. 1, 2, 3, 4. Not that tough. But then we get this 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so you're going to be doing this thing with your hand where you're going to go sixth string, and then kind of like the fourth and third strings. It's the middle of the strings. And then you're going to do the higher part, which is like the third and second strings. Okay, so you're going to go sixth, middle, treble strings. Okay, you're actually going to do it like this. I misled you. It's down, down, up. Not down, down, down. It's going to be down, down, up, down, down, up. So what is that? That's actually the sixth fret. You back the index finger down while your ring finger is still on the sixth fret there, if you can see. Sixth fret. Okay. Down, down, up, down, down, up. I need to stop doing that during this tutorial. It is down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up. So you're going to sixth fret, back down that finger, and then you can do your middle finger on your eighth fret. So eighth fret, both of those fingers are going to slide over. Okay. Down, down, up. You're going to bring the index finger back to the seventh fret. Okay, so it's going to go sixth, fifth, eighth, seventh. And if you notice, after I hit the seventh, gonna emphasize that one because that's what's actually gonna go. It's gonna help you kind of slide and get back to the beat where it's back to four. Okay, so we're gonna do 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Did you notice I emphasized the two there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up. Okay, so that's pretty much the most of the intro, and then you got this little melodic lick they like to throw in there. 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, and. So we're back to this third fret again. This is our full G chord without the B in the third. You're gonna do your let go, and then you're gonna do your first fret of the first string, and then open. So these are both on up strums because we're playing them on the off beat. So 1, 2, 3, and. Try and count along. 1, 2, 3, and that's where you're gonna do the melodic stuff. 1, 2, 3, and. And once you do that and, you're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So I'll show you 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. Loop it for ya. Just loop that, play along with the thing that I'm doing, right? And it just kind of keeps going over and over again till it sounds nice and clean and smooth, and then you can, you know, take over the world, right? Okay, naturally. So that's basically it for the entire intro, and you have that same thing for the first verse, or you could say the first half of kind of the verse if you want to divide the verse into two parts like that. But I'll just say the first verse, which is up to something for the rag and bone man on my dead body. Something big is gonna happen. Oh, something big is gonna happen on my dead body. So that part, we're gonna keep doing the same thing, okay? No big deal. But the next part, someone saw someone's daughter, okay? We're gonna lead into this section with one. You see that? So we did one of the ones that we did before. Okay, we'll just call that our first figure. And then we have a second figure. So this other guitar riff that comes in is similar, okay? You're gonna go 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So the rhythmic emphasis is the same. Your strumming is gonna be the same. Down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up. Okay, with that emphasis on that final down. And except you're gonna do your fingers a little bit differently. It's gonna go X 6, okay, and then you're gonna do sort of like an X 0 6 6, and then you're gonna go back to the sixth string there. So 6 X 0 0 6 6. And both times you're kind of muting the string directly under the string that the middle finger is depressing. I'm gonna do the same thing on the eighth fret here. Should emphasize that one. So okay, so that's gonna help you. 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so there you go. So that's figure two. Figure one and figure two continue to alternate during this second verse, or what some might call the second half of the verse. So I'll show you what I mean. Drop my pick. Happens to the best of us. Someone saw someone's daughter. one. This is how I end up sucked in figure two. Figure two. Over my dead body. Figure two. And then we go to here. So say goodbye to the verse section. You're never going to play that again. And we're going to go to this, what you could call, I guess, a chorus. Okay. I'm going to go to sleep. Let this wash all over me. Okay. So this, what is this? This is actually a thumb used, like a thumb chord, a thumb using chord, I was going to say, but that didn't sound intelligent, so I stopped myself. So, geez, 6, 8, X, 0, 6, 8 again. Okay, so that's my my thumb, my ring, and then my index, and then my pinky. Muting the fourth string. Did you see that? I just do the same shape, okay, to the 8th fret. So back to the 6th, and then to the 5th. So 6th fret. 8th fret, I'm referring to the thumb, 6th fret, 5th fret. I'm real creative, Tom. Ah, he knows I'm kidding. So how do you do the timing? It's a 1, 2, 3, 4, I'm sorry, 1 and 2 and 3 and up, E and a 4, E and up. Saying you've been following these if you've been following these tutorials long enough, you'd realize that I'm using some rhythmic vocalizations for 16th notes. So we divide up the phrase of what we're playing. We could divide it up into four main beats: 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we got eighth notes. Okay, we can divide those up again. So those were quarter notes. We can divide into eighth notes. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and then we got 16th notes. You subdivide again. 1 and 2 and a 3 and a 4 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and 1 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 and a Now, if you notice, I'm after the I'm kind of deep, kind of taking the pressure off of the strings there. When I take the pressure off, it stops ringing out, okay? Helps you kind of emphasize a rhythm, okay? Gives you a little bit, sort of like a groove there. And now we're going to move on to the next section. This is the tough part. Actually, I think the first part is the hardest, figure one and figure two, but this is pretty difficult just in terms of your rhythm. So people who struggle with rhythm, you're going to have to take this part slow. So you're going to go 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a E. It doesn't even start on a 1. 4E and a E. So it starts on the A of 4. Okay, so and 2E and a E. Sorry, I said 2. And a 4E and a E. So what is that right there? I'm actually doing 3, 3, X, 0, XX. 3, 3, X, 0, XX. So I'm not even strumming the second and first strings. I'm just strumming this part with my up strum. And then I go, this is like your full G chord from the beginning. So 3, X, 0, 0, 3. And Tom doesn't really play the first string there. Okay? So you're going to see this chord, which is like a G sus4. to a G with no thirds. Some people call that a G5. So G sus 4 to the G5. Now, in between those two up strums, you actually hear me strumming down muted. So up. So how do I do that? I actually can hit the strings like that with the side of my palm. I'm going to go chop like that, okay? Kind of makes it sound cool, right? Sorry, I played that wrong. So we got E. So what were those two chords? It goes like this. So you can use your middle finger on your 6th fret, X, and then your ring finger on your 4th string, 7th fret, and then you're going to hold your 4th string on your 5th fret, okay? And your 3rd string on your 5th fret. So your index finger is going to cover two strings there. And then XX, so. And then when your ring finger is there, you're basically going to mute the 3rd string. So you really only hear the 6th and the 4th strings. And then when you release, you hear the 6th, 4th, and 3rd strings there, okay? So it's a little complicated, but you'll hear it. It goes like this. Only two notes and then 3 notes there. And then you add your ring finger where it was before on the 3rd string. You're actually going to take it and bring it to the 2nd string, 6th fret. So it's going to be 6x556. Then you do a down strum. Up, up, down. Up, 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 down. You're going to have that note kind of on that down strum. And after I do my ups, you notice I'm just filling it in. So I'm going up, up, strum, strum, strum. And keep strumming. Keep strumming up. And then just like when I make that noise, it's just like my noise for like, oh, keep strumming. Like you guys would understand. But the next one is 8, 10, X, 10, 8. Okay? X. So you can use your thumb again. So thumb, ring, X, pinky, index, and then so those two up strums, you're gonna have two different chords. You're gonna have this 8 10 x 10 8, then you're gonna have 8 10 x 9 with your middle finger. You'll notice this shape is actually the shape that Tom uses from the basement for Reckoner. But anyways, this is a C sus to a C, okay? So you got your G sus 4 to a G, but G5. What did I call it? I didn't give this a name. This is actually a B major 9 with no third and no fifth, and then release to a B 6 9 with no third and no fifth. And then you get a, what is that? Oh, that's a B 6 9 with a fifth, no third. So, yeah. Whatever, it's a chord name. Sounds cool, don't need to name it, but theory geeks want to know. Okay, so C sus 4. And the coolest thing about this part is actually just cycles. These three chords cycle, 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 one measure each. And they're actually not going to be a four measure phrase, which is typically what you hear in a lot of music. It's just four chords or, you know, a couple chords and then one chord for two measures. You're going to hear four chords cycle a lot. This is actually a got one short, and that makes it feel like you keep kind of like looping yourself in, which is pretty cool. Third chord, first chord again, second chord. There you go, right? Okay. Now, so that's the part that keeps looping, 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 and that's the part where you sing, "We don't really want a monster taking over." Okay. And, there's this part, actually, and I should really insert this, actually, between the chorus and this sort of bridge part, "We don't really want a monster," the part that you sing that part over. It should be... Uh, I forgot this. I'm going to insert this part now, okay? So put it in there later. So you're going to actually go like this. G4, B flat kind of chord. Again. Third time, right? And on the third time, you go to the C chord. Same thing. And you're going to go like this. All up strums while you're strumming continuously. Keep your hand moving continuously. So it's going to be G sus 4 to G5 to G sus 4. G sus 4 again, G sus 4 again, then G5. Okay, so it's going to be 4, 5, 4, 4, 4, 5, and you'll hear it. I'll loop it for you. All up strums. Keep trying to do the thing with the beat, right? That one's wrong. 4, 5, 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 5, 4, 4, 4, 5. Okay, and once you end that thing like that, you're gonna hear the singing start there. We don't really want a monster taking over. That's where you go, okay? So I'll show you the whole thing all together from I'm gonna go to sleep. I'm gonna go to sleep and let this wash all over me. Second time. G to B flat. Third time. C chord. 4, 5, 4, 4, 4, 5. What a monster. Taking over. This is where you're looping the three chords. They keep looping in. Tiptoeing. Tying down. Keeps looping. Now we don't want the loonies taking over. Tiptoeing. Does this crazy thing. I'm gonna go to sleep and let this wash all over me. I made that major. Over me. There we go. It's minor there. Okay. Or bluesy, actually. Blues scale. Anyway, so that is basically where you get that come back, that this part comes back again, so the chorus comes back. I'm sorry, it's a little late, not coherent right now, but may pretty horses come to you as you sleep. I'm gonna go to sleep and let this wash all over me, and you're gonna end. Depending on which version you listen to, you actually hear that part where it does the G to B flat three times and then to the C chord and then to the 4, 5, 4, 4, 4, 5. Or you can hear the three chord repeating looping thing. So depending on the version you check out, you can kind of decide to end it how you want to end it. Only the way that I really like to end it is the one that I saw on this one live acoustic performance, where you go 4, 5, 4, 4. What happened to the song? It's like done and like, oh, what? Confusing. But anyway, this tutorial's gotten way too long. So hopefully you guys can take your time with this. I tell all my students, really learn to value the work that you put in more than the actual song that you play in the end. The song is actually just a reflection of your growth as a musician. And that's the important part, is that you grow as a musician while you're learning to play these songs. The song, of course, it's nice to be able to play the song, but value the work you're putting in, and you're really going to be able to persevere. Even though you don't get to see the song come out right away, you should know that there is the work that you're actually putting into it. So plug is, you know, I teach over Skype, in case you guys didn't know. If this is not slow enough for you, if you have more specific questions, please reach out to me. We can talk over email or over Skype. My Skype name is just my name, Warren Lane, W-A-R-R-E-N-L-A-I-N. And my email is warren@warrenlane.com. So there you go. Please contact me. And if you guys don't want to wait for another few years to get the next tutorial that you're really, really, really begging for, I do tutorials for hire. They're like little projects I do, and I charge hourly for that. So just email me with your info there, and let me know what song it is that you'd love to hear. I can actually tab anything out. I can do video tab is essentially what we're doing here, for any song you can think of. It doesn't even have to be a guitar song. We can make it into guitar. We can do it into something else. You interpret it, right? And is that it? Am I leaving anything out? In front of thousands of people. Yeah, I don't think there's anything I'm leaving out. Okay, well, that's it. Okay, take care, and sorry for wasting your time with the ums. Please come back again soon. I love you guys. Bye.